the Kwacha over time has been losing value, a lot of value, and of late losing substantial value against the dollar and other convertible currencies very, very rapidly. We all know that. The implication of this Kwacha losing value, our currency losing value, is broad. Many aspects get affected by the Kwacha losing value. One of the critical aspects is the increase in the cost of living. As the Kwacha depreciates, it increases the cost of doing business, it increases the cost of living, it increases the cost of melimel, the cost of salt, the cost of sugar to the households. And obviously, it increases invariably the cost of running business. If you're an importer, you now have to find more Kwacha to import the same quantity of goods that you may have imported last year. Those goods may be for manufacturing, they may be for resale. The cost just goes up because the Kwacha is losing too much value. And the Kwacha losing value is a reflection of the failure of leadership to a large extent, as we see it here. The inability to manage variables that are very important, extremely important, certain policy aspects, in particular, monetary policy. But monetary policy alone cannot contain the loss of value in our currency. This must be coupled with the fiscal policies. It's a package, it's a combination of measures that we will put in place, because we need to restore the Kwacha's value, to stabilize it, so that it's easier to plan in business, it's easier to plan in a household, for especially low-income earners in our households, in our families, who are many, who are the majority. They need to be able to know that in the following month, given their income, which is largely static, constant, which is not increasing because it's difficult to increase salaries these days because businesses are going down, they know that they'll be able to feed their families. So stability is very important. So we'll move very quickly by enhancing the monetary policy aspects, but combine that with fiscal policies, because it's that package that will bring results in our efforts to stabilize the Kwacha. And in addition to that, we'll be looking at the trade side of our economy, a trade policy to make sure that we increase our exports as much as possible. But you see, increasing exports is an orchestrated plan. It's an orchestrated program for us in the UPND. It has to deal with also first increasing investments. But we can't increase investments without an attractive investment policy. So we'll put in place attractive investment policies and then trade policies combined with consistency. You can't keep on changing policies every now and then. You send the wrong message in the investment community. So we stabilize the policies so that they are predictable. One can plan. Planning is not just short, medium term, it's long term as well, especially certain investments. And we will also make a particular effort in supporting value addition in our country, increasing the value of the raw commodities that we produce. For example, in today's Zambia, manganese is mined and is sold by and large in a raw form, rocks. And it's only attracting somewhere in the region of $50 per ton. But we plan as UPND to value add this manganese by investing in the manganese processing plants in the manganese production areas. And that to be able, that will allow us to increase the value per ton to well over $1,500 per ton. Just imagine the difference, the stark difference. All of that additional value would allow us to export more, you know, maybe, you know, manganese, but more importantly, any more from the manganese that we export. And by increasing our foreign exchange earnings, the supply side of the Kwacha improves. It means, sorry, of the dollars improves. It means we can stabilize the Kwacha. That's extremely important because, you know, if you have a shortage of foreign exchange, it means that your Kwacha keeps on losing value. And we'll work very, very seriously on that. So growing economy, increasing exports, making sure that we reduce our expenditure on consumption and increase the expenditure deliberately, for that matter, on the investment, and therefore growth will arise from there. Inevitably also, it's not just managing the Kwacha, but it helps create jobs, creates, if you like, business opportunities for our people, including the youth, the women, and other citizens. This is very, very important. But lastly, amongst other factors that will help us and will focus on to stabilize the Kwacha, is to work on this commodity called confidence, to improve the confidence in the economy, in the market. Because if you don't have confidence, as is the case now, the Kwacha takes additional hammering, serious hammering. So we believe, because of the leadership, visionary leadership that we have, because of our ability to manage the country's resources in a prudent way, because of our ability to prioritize where we spend the limited resources, as we all know, resources are always limited, in the investment area and less in consumption area, we will not really be buying in the UPND government. It will be taboo to buy a $65 million jet for one or two people, when we can use that $65 million, for example, to invest in a solar power station that will give us a lot of megawatts that will help boost the electricity supply, reduce load shedding, which is extremely important to provide consistent electricity supply, energy supply to our factories, to our homes, you know, to education, to health. Very, very critical, because you can lose a life on the operating table in a hospital because you've lost energy, which is electricity. You have lost oxygen, which is driven by electricity. All those components are interlinked, and we'll make sure that we drive them in a matrix, in a way that will grow the economy. And obviously, that can only happen because we have the vision, we have the leadership, which has the vision, a leadership which has the ability to manage resources prudently, a leadership which has the ability to monitor things that go wrong and correct them quickly. That is what will drive more confidence in the market, and obviously help shower up, we call it shower up the Kwacha, and stabilize the Kwacha, and bring about consistency in the currency market, as well as obviously in the real economy, which is the productive side of the economy.